This video is about bandwidth management in Hyper-V. Before I get into that, I want to give you an idea of what the demo setup will look like. So the first thing we've got is this machine called Speedy1. And on Speedy1 is running Hyper-V, and there are four virtual machines. There's a web front end, a mid-tier, a database, and then an Active Directory. And then there's another machine called Speedy2, and it's got source data on it for those other systems. I'll explain that in a minute. And the virtual machines have shares for Speedy2. So Speedy2 is going to connect to shares that are in those virtual machines. And then each one of the virtual machines has a vSwitch and adapter. So each VM has its own vSwitch and LAN port. So they're all coming directly out into the network, which is a 1 gigabit network connected between Speedy1 and Speedy2. And then we're going to attempt to throttle the bandwidth on each one of those vSwitches that are associated with each one of those virtual machines. And then the shares on Speedy2 are a web front end share that will connect here, mid-tier share which connects here, database share which connects here, and then an AD share which connects to the AD virtual machine as well. So that's the setup. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the environment. Okay. So the systems, you have Speedy1 here with Hyper-V Manager, and then the actual virtual machines that are running on Hyper-V, and then you've got Speedy2, which has these shares that go into each one of these virtual machines. And then I've got some folders where we're going to be transferring data between the data that's on SSD2 and Speedy2 into those shares, which then ends up in those virtual machines. With bandwidth management, we'll be able to manage or throttle some of that data speed between those two environments. One big fact here is that bandwidth management only manages outbound data. So it would be outbound from the actual virtual machine to Speedy2. So for inbound into those virtual machines, so let's take this test folder and bring it down and copy it from Speedy2 into the virtual machine AD share. And you can see it's going by. You can see the speed is about 113 megabytes a second. Pretty good. I've got SSDs on both of these machines, so the data transfers very quickly. Now, if we take the test folder from the share, and I'll just bring it up here to this inbound to Speedy2, you can see it's about the same. So it's coming off that other SSD that's on Speedy1 in a virtual machine, by the way, and then coming into this inbound to Speedy2 folder. Almost done. Okay, so that was outbound from Speedy1. So let's take a look at this environment. We've got a web front end, a middle tier, a database, and then Active Directory. Okay, so which one of these machines would need to have, say, bandwidth throttling? Well, the web front end pretty much needs as much bandwidth as it can get because you've got people making requests of it. And then also you're responding to those requests with pages and text and graphics files and what have you. So your outbound data out of this virtual machine probably shouldn't have any bandwidth control on it at all. Then the mid-tier, well, the mid-tier is primarily for running the applications. So things like shopping carts and purchasing environments or applications of a wide variety of types. And then the database, from a previous video, we know that it needs a lot of IOPS and that it probably needs a bit of compute power and it could consume a lot of memory. But in terms of bandwidth, it may need more outbound bandwidth than, say, the mid-tier. And so you may want to allow people to do queries into that database and get a lot of data back. So you may not want to mess with that one either. And then there's Active Directory. Well, Active Directory doesn't really do much in this environment. It responds to requests for authentication and then just delivers the authentication package, which is not that large. And it's probably fairly infrequent unless you've got an extremely busy website that where people are logging in constantly and registering and those types of things. So Active Directory is probably the one that is most likely to be limited in terms of outbound bandwidth. So how would we do that? Well, you'd go to settings. And in the settings, there's a network adapter. And you go there and you can see that you can select enable bandwidth management. So there's the minimum bandwidth and the maximum bandwidth. Let's just give this a maximum bandwidth of 50 megabits a second. That should be able to handle a lot of responses to authentication requests. Okay, and the virtual machine is actually running when I did that, so it is hot. It can be live when you make those changes. So we were on Speedy 2, and we had this test folder that we brought down to the 80 share, and we had 100 megabytes a second, 110 megabytes a second in both directions. So now let's do that test folder outbound out of Active Directory, the Active Directory virtual machine, and see what happens. So you can see that it is limiting the bandwidth out of that virtual machine. And so we're getting anywhere from 4.5 to 6 megabytes a second by limiting the bandwidth out of the Active Directory virtual machine. To save some time, I stopped that one file transfer and then downloaded a bunch of the files to the folders where we're going to upload them into Speedy 2 again after we've throttled the bandwidth or managed the bandwidth. Let's go ahead and look at some of the properties here and make some changes to bandwidth throttling. So for the mid-tier, let's go ahead and give it a maximum of 100 megabits a second. Say OK. And then for the database, we want it to have a fair amount of outbound bandwidth, so we're going to give it 500 megabits a second. Say OK. And then the Active Directory, we've already set pretty low. And we're going to go ahead and leave it right there. Now, we've got all this set. The web front end is unlimited. We set the mid-tier and the database and already had Active Directory. Now let's go back over here to Speedy 2 and pull these folders off of the systems, off of the virtual machines, into this inbound to Speedy 2. So that's the web front end. You can see it's basically the maximum speed. I'm going to go ahead and pause that. We're getting about 113 megabytes a second. And then for the mid-tier, in terms of the total speed, it's 16.2 and falling. And the database folder should be higher. There we go. It's 57, almost 60 megabytes a second. Go ahead and pause that. And then the AD. Is very slow because we set it to 50. Now let's go ahead and start all of these. So you can see the difference. There's the AD, which is set very low at 6 megabytes a second. The database share, which we gave it 500 megabits a second, and then the mid-tier with 100, and then the web front end was unlimited. So even though transfer a lot of files, even though that one file transfer completed, it hasn't significantly changed the speed of the other file transfers because they're throttled. The bandwidth is managed and limited by the network settings, the bandwidth management settings in Hyper-V. So I'm going to just let that run out. And with that, I want to thank you for watching, and hopefully this was a little bit informative.